Dear friends, the Federation of Cuban Women greet the celebration of this meeting in honor to the International Women's Celebration. My name is Gretel Marante Roset and I am a Foreign Affairs of the Cuban Women Federation. The Cuban Women Federation is a national social organization that was created on August 23, 1960, thanks to support and dedication to Vilma Espín and Fidel Castro. The responsibility for this task was assigned to Vilma Espín Guillot since its creation the organization. Since the very beginning of the revolution, our eternal commander-in-chief, Fidel Castro, said, "Women in Cuba is a revolution within another revolution." The Cuban Women Federation is a clear expression of united in all Cuban women. We contend that more than 4 million affiliates, that it represents more than 91% of women population older 14 years. It is only conditioned to be a member and it is a completely volunteer. 2020 has been a different year. We celebrate the 60th anniversary of the creation of the Cuban Women Federation in difficult times. A complex context for the humanity marked by the pandemic of the COVID-19, together with other diseases that affect development, such as environmental degradation, the unequal distribution of resources, war, the new kind, amongst others, have imposed by the several tests for sustainability of the human space. We learn many things in a short time, to express love to family, to friends, to replace visit with call, to become an active user of cyberspace, meeting, exchange, and only online forums have been incorporated into the work agenda. We learn to apply the physical distancing, to incorporate the protection mask and other means in our daily life. Kiss and hugs have been saved for the future times. Endless have been the effort of our state, the government, the state and the political and massive organization. The extensive working hour that our health personnel and the entire people have done. The beautiful and noble task for saving lives, solidarity, no borders, and collaborating medical brigades and give their service and provide their aid in many countries impacted by the pandemic. At this context, Cuba have been the object of sanction measure, destabilizing campaign, and discrediting media manipulation that paid by the United States focus on destroyed our social project. The economic, financial, and commercial blockade imposed by the government of the United States is an act of war, which prevents American people themselves, the most affected by the lethal disease, from receiving solidarity help from Cuban medical collaboration. However, in the middle of such aggressive campaign, Cuba has been able to face this pandemic. All variations of the health protocol have been applied without leaving anyone helpless. International recognition has not been lacking, and the word thank you with another expression of gratitude have been heard from all continents. Cuba is not a perfect society. There are still many pending challenges to face, challenges to overcome, and things to be perfect, but it's a paradigm of dignity and social justice. It has been 62 years of sacrifice, resistance, and victories, and in which together men and women have been protagonists of our own revolution history. We are very grateful for your solidarity in demanding and the end of the immoral induced blockade imposed by the government of the United States on our people for over 50 years on, against the will of the international community, on the fact that he has been crushingly condemned by the UN General Assembly. The Cuban women identified the blockade as the worst form of violence exercised against women and the entire people. This policy prevents the successful and continuous process of the empowerment of the Cuban women in the society and the achievement of the Sustainable Development Goal, in particular number 5, referring to the issue of the gender equality. The blockade has been the most extensive and injustice in which any nation has been subjected through history, and without a doubt, it constitutes the main obstacle of our development of the country. Satisfaction of food needs constitute the permanent source of tension of our women, who are still primarily responsible for domestic tasks. The blockade makes it difficult for families to accompany their daughter and son in the fulfillment of their school duties, and they not have a sufficient supply or teaching material, toys, and other that facilitate learning. Women in Cuba are inserted in the current process of the corporatization of the society. We have present a social network, and we make effective use of the access of the internet and email. Despite the incessant media campaigns organized by the imperialist neighbor, with the firm intention of destroying the Cuban Revolution and denigrating the image of the women, the Federation of Cuban Women have been recognized by the government and the society as a national mechanism for the advancement of women due to its extensive work at the grassroots level, its role in the introduction of gender concept in the institutional agenda and the public policies, its work for the complete integration of women to the economic, political, social, and cultural life in the country. The Cuban Women Federation has a legislative power. This condition to bring us the possibility to promote laws and public policy with gender perspective. The Cuban Women Federation has get the special consultative status with the ECOSOC. ECOSOC is the Economic and Social Council at the United Nations since 1997. This facilitates our participation in the council session, and also it is functional commission, fundamental in the Commission of the Status of Women and the Human Rights Council. It also enables us to present periodic oral and written contribution regarding the work of our organization. The Cuban Women Federation is also a member of the international movement and organization, such as the Women International Democratic Federation, the Conference of the NGO, the International Council of the Social Welfare, and the World Women March, among others. The Federation of Cuban Women coordinates the regional office of the International Democratic Women Federation to organize the work of the World Organization of Latin American and the Caribbean. This induced blockade imposed by the United States government limit the result of the FNC work. For example, if we are the key obstacle to obtaining material for the textile production of the Artisan Center El Quitrín, our publishing house is an institution created by the Cuban Women Federation, feel the impacts of the unilateral policy as access to the public is limited. Cuba is ours. It belongs to the Cuban people, and we will continue as an example of a free and sovereign nation. It's solidarity time. Thank you.